can do this. Why do I take pictures? Hi guys. So, I used to take pictures a lot when I was young, and my parents thought I was just wasting my time, which is probably true. And they forced me to go to law school, which I did. I'm a lawyer. I am. And then I graduated law school in Belgium, from Belgium, and I went to South Africa with my wife, who's not here right now, but she went there with me. And we had a car, and we worked in a township in South Africa where people don't have much at all. Hi, Allison. And these people didn't have much, and we had a car, and so we'll drive you home, because this is a township, 10,000 people, rural. Is this microphone supposed to turn off?
No.
Okay. So I'm gonna build a wall. No. So the township is big, and people walk for hours to come to the health center where we work. And we have a car, so we would tell people, you know, we'll take you home. Well, you don't have to walk home. And people would say, no, we want to walk home. We don't want a car ride. So we would just go to our place and, why the fuck do they not want a ride? And so one day we found out, and so a woman told me that, sure, it takes her 45 minutes to get home, but she's strolling around and sees her neighbor, talks to her neighbor, and has a good conversation, and it fills her with joy. And there's a sense of community that we don't have, we've completely lost. And so I'm sure I'm taking pictures back home of the fall and leaves and cute girls and stuff like that. But now I'm in this country where people open this whole world up to me. And so I'm poor. This is kind of like a Peace Corps job. So, except we live with like $700 a month, which is way more than Peace Corps. And we had a car. Peace Corps volunteers and a car. Anyways, we were like living it up. And the point is, I started taking pictures, film, which was way too expensive, and it sucked when it came back, and was developing new software. But I couldn't stop myself. Like, I have to tell people what life is like in this other world. And that's why I take pictures. And so I still take pictures, but I try to focus on what I don't want to leave behind. If I walk past something, I want to take pictures all the time, but I only really convince myself to go ahead and do it when I feel like I'll be pissed if I don't take that picture. And if I go home and I didn't take that picture, and sometimes it's inappropriate, which is a balance you have to work with. But, so just that time, I didn't see the weapon yet. Okay. So, two more things. So, my favorite picture is the migrant mother. So if you have a phone and you want to Google migrant mother images, it's Dorothea Lange, right? It's lady like this. But that's not my, but my point is, if you look at the picture, a lot of people look at the picture and they'll see desperation. And that's not what I see. And in fact, I think that's patronizing. So I think this woman is super strong. I think she's pissed. I love Dorothy Lane, my favorite photographer, but this lady, Florence Owen, I can't think of her last name now, but her first name is Florence Thompson. she's a strong lady. She has three kids at that point, and she's on her way. We're talking about Santa Cruz here. So she's on her way to Santa. This picture was taken in Southern, I don't know how many people know, but this picture was taken in Southern California. She comes from Oklahoma. She's what people here call the Okies. So it's in the 30s. So she's a refugee from Dust Bowl, coming to Southern California. Picture's taken by Dorothy Lang. She's getting on Highway 101 to get to Watsonville to pick lettuce in the fields. Yeah. And so this lady at that point is about 30 years old, and she is strong, and she doesn't want this picture to be taken. And she goes on, picks lettuce in the fields, and becomes 80 years old, dies of cancer in a hospital in Scotts Valley, is buried in Modesto, had 10 kids. She made it. Like, if you look at the picture, and if people say that's desperate, it's not desperation, that is strength. That's human resilience. And I love human resilience. And if you go to Africa or any, it's like, I'm obsessed with human resilience. That's why I take pictures. Thank you, guys. This is so much fun.
Thank you.